Today we're going to do an upgrade on this wood saw. It originally had a fixed single speed induction motor. We're going to swap out that motor with two different variable speed servo motors. It will turn this saw from a wood only saw into a saw that's capable of cutting metal. Metal as large as this one that it just cut recently, or even larger. These are the motors that we're going to use. The one on the left, the largest one, is the original motor. It has a fixed speed of 1,700 RPMs. It's 1 horsepower. The one next to it is 2 horsepower, and the one farthest to the right is actually 1.2 horsepower. Servo motors can produce considerably more power for this size. At 1700 RPMs, this motor on the slow speed was a 1-to-1 ratio. That means 1700 feet a minute blade speed. These motors over here are turning 0.75 to 1. So if the motor is running 400 RPMs, the blade is running 300 feet per minute. We are able to achieve as slow as 200 feet per minute and as high as 2600 feet per minute, which pretty much gives us the full range. For almost any wood cutting and almost any metal cutting, it's not slow enough to cut high-speed steel. But who's going to cut that? I'm sure not going to. I will proceed and show you some of the tests with the different blades. And then we'll go into it with a little bit more detail. These are the blades we're going to use in the test today. This one is the original wood cutting blade. It is 1/4 inch wide. I don't know how thick it is. These Lennox Die Masters are one of my favorite blades to cut metal. 1/2 inch this way, 0.025 thick. Generally, they flex well, they work well, they cut all different grades of steel. Of course, you don't want to go too hard of steel, but they'll cut mild steel any day of the week. This Die Master is 8/12. Means it'll cut steel as thin as, 1/8 of an inch and upwards of 3/16, maybe a little thicker. This is a Zanot made in Germany. It is a 4/6. This is what you're going to want to use to cut thicker stuff like this aluminum here, or even thicker. This is a DeWalt. It is made in USA. It is also the same tooth count as the Die Master, but it's 3/4 inch this way, and it's 0.035 thick. You really need to have the 2 horsepower to run these blades. This blade runs great, and you can get this blade in teeth like this too, and you can run it with the 1.2 easy. Next up, we're going to do some cuts. This is the 900 watt motor, 1.2 horsepower. This is 400 RPM. That's 300 feet a minute. Mild steel. Lennox Die Master 8x12. It's 1/2 inch this way, 0.025 thick. Steel is 3/16 of an inch thick, oh, maybe 1.5 inches, 2 inches long. That's 300 feet a minute. That's the specified speed to cut this steel. I've ran it at 500 RPMs. That'd be 400 feet a minute. Cuts it a lot faster. But they say use this speed so that you don't burn up your saw blades. We're going to cut 1/8 inch thick by 1.5 inch wide, 6061 aluminum. We're going to run the saw blade at 600 RPMs, which is about 475 feet a minute. Slight radius as possible. Not bad. Okay, we installed the original wood saw blade. It's about 6 teeth per inch. It's a hook saw, 1/4 inch wide. I don't know what the thickness is. Used to run at about 2,000 RPMs. We're going to run it at 1,000 RPMs. I don't see any need to run it at 2,000 RPMs. Even though we can run it as high as 3,500. Go hard, no problem cutting at 1200 RPMs. I don't see any reason to run it at 2000 RPMs like they used to. Okay, this is a made in Germany blade provided by LA Cutting Products. It's a 4x6 tooth, means 4 tooth to 6 tooth per inch. It is 3/4 inch wide. It is 0.035 thick. We're going to try to cut a piece of solid 6061 aluminum 3 1/4 inch in diameter. We're going to bump the saw speed up to, well, actually we're going to bump the RPMs of the motor up to 1200. Still haven't calculated the saw speed for that and see what happens. Here we go. Say that isn't too bad for the small motor. Be a lot better if I had a vise set up and get a straighter cut. Actually, I could get a perfect cut. Also, as I changed this, that the motor speed did load up a little bit. I would suggest for the thicker blades, if you're going to go with a 0.35 thickness blade, that you consider the 2 horsepower versus the 1.2 horsepower. I am now convinced that is what I will keep on this machine. We're going to do a remove and replace. We're going to pull out the 1.2 horsepower and put in the two horsepower. It's just a simple swap out. We'll also show you how to line up the belt with your system while we're doing it. Shouldn't take very long. Loosen this. Loosen the belt. Take the belt off. Pull this nut. Actually, it's a bolt. Pull this wheel. Get the belt out of the way. Pull the motor mounting bolts. Hang on to the motor or have somebody grab the other end so it doesn't fall out on the floor. That's it. Old motor's out. That's a 900 watt 1.2 with the mounting plate. This plate will not be on when it comes in the box. This is the 2 horsepower. Comes with the plate, won't be installed in the box. This is your adjustment. Set it in place. Line up a hole. Get number 2 started. You should be able to go around the front by then. Number 3. Number 4. Tighten them up. They don't need to be too tight. If you make them too tight, you're going to strip out that plate. If you strip out that plate, you're going to have to buy a new one because I'm not going to fix it for you for free. Line the pulley is really easy. Put your wrench in, Allen wrench in, get it to the right spot where it's ready to lock. Just put a straight edge. Line this up with the pulley and the other one, and it's done. Just lock it in place right there. Belt. Pulley. Belt on there in the right spot so it doesn't get pinched. Goes on the larger one of the two for the lower speed. Use the right wrench, might help. That's part of getting old. Eyesight sucks. Take a closer look, make sure the belt's sitting in the right spot. Tighten the belt. Make sure it feels about right. Plug it in. turn it on, and test it. And we're ready to go. The install kit will come with this bracket to mount your control unit. Just unscrew this little, I guess it's an Allen wrench holder or something. Never used it. Screw the bracket in instead. Like that. Again, do not over tighten. Take the control unit, put it in the bracket. Tighten it up, plug it in, secure your wires, and you're good to go.